Hello everyone, I am R. Verma and in today's video we are going to study regarding importance of reading. Importance of reading, you might be thinking what's this reading and just a boring video ma'am is preparing. But focusing on language, as in my previous video I told you that if you want to learn any language, there must be your passion regarding anything. And if you are interested to learn any language, you must be passionate, you must love that language, then only you are able to understand, then only you can train your mind to get that language. So focusing on that, I thought that we are going to start the simplest and easiest way to learn that particular language, and that is importance of reading. Importance of reading, unfortunately we are, some of us, very least number of two participants or very least number of person concentrate towards reading, and the credit goes to our smartphone, cell phones, and these are the reasons we are not concentrating towards our reading sessions. But as you know that the person, those who are having the reading habit, they have much more vocabulary, they have speaking skills, they have writing skill as well. So you might be thinking that man is telling that go for reading, what to read, your focus is that go for magazines, go for newspaper, go for novel, go for storybooks. According to your interest, according to your mindset, you can go for your reading sections. And in that, if you are going for magazine and newspaper, it will inculcate formal languages. And what for informal languages? Informal languages can be inculcated through novels and storybooks. So these two things can inculcate many things in you. And how to read? How to read means read it loudly. You might be thinking that ma'am is telling that how to read loudly. We are standing in a kiosk, we are standing in a family member that we are at the how to read. But if you have trained your mind to learn any language, then you must read anything loudly, because your tongue is influenced by your mother tongue. And to influence that with your English language, which you are interested to learn, you have to prepare your mind to read it loudly. That means each word which you are reading, it must be felt by your mind, felt by your tongue, felt by your vocal cords, so that it is easily convenient for you to communicate with any of you. Secondly, read it silently. As you are going through louder, you can feel that language. In the same way, if you are going to read it once or twice or thrice, try to understand. Through silent reading, try to understand what the contents are, what the summary is, what the writer or author or poet wants to say in that particular chapter or in a particular novel, storybook, whatever you are interested for. Third is, after reading, it might be louder, might be silent, recollect the things. Accordingly, whatever you have read it out, close your eyes, recollect all the things, summarize it, and try to converse with each other, any of your near and dear ones. If no one is there, you just inculcate all the information in your mind and try to understand what the person tried to convey through their playwrights or through their study materials. Secondly, underline the new expressions and new words. That means as you are going for newspaper, magazine, novel, storybooks, many new expressions, many new words you might come across. So underline those words with the help of good dictionary, go through the meaning, try to understand the meaning and use it in your day-to-day conversations. Third point is that you might be thinking, as ma'am is telling that go for reading, how to read it out. After going through all this process, what are the uses? As you will prepare a habit of at least 30 minutes reading, you will get uses of reading. First one, reading at least 30 minutes. I know that you have such a crucial situation. It is not able to continue for more than 30 minutes. But you have a habit of 30 minutes reading. If you have been having the habit of 30 minutes reading, it will enrich your vocabulary. You will learn many more words. And as you will enrich your vocabulary, you will become a great speaker, great orator, great writer. As you know that, those who are having the habit of reading, they are a great speaker. They write beautifully. They can share their views in a very precise and content way. So, that's all for today. I hope you will like my video. Thank you.